talking all year long about how important kindergarten is and how it helps us prepare for our futures. We've also been talking about how sometimes we change our mind about what we want to be when we grow up, from princesses to doctors. So this is some of their future plans that they have for what they might want to be when they grow up. Lincoln, go ahead and start us off. Remember, we're going to start with I am a future.
I'm a future NBA basketball player.
I'm a future Air Force pilot.
I'm a future electrical engineer.
I'm a future Air Force
pilot. I'm a future doctor.
I'm a future Army soldier.
I'm a future teacher.
I'm a future actor.
I'm a future baseball player.
I'm a future artist.
I'm a future teacher.
I'm a future teacher.
I'm a future army girl.
I'm a future singer.
I'm a future basketball
player. I'm a future teacher.
I'm a future teacher.
Isaac, you boy, you keep me on my toes because you're always asking me great questions, and sometimes I have to look them up. So you're getting the I must ask you a question.
I must ask you a question.
Devin, you see, look at the smile. He is the guy who keeps us laughing all the time. Appropriate, but he's always got something good. So he's getting the class comedian because you always make us LOL, laugh out loud. Betsy is the girl who walks through the door first thing in the morning, and when she goes home, and when she's reading, and she always has something on her face.
A smile.
A smile. So she's getting the super smile award. You can just hold it in front of you, honey. And if the hats fall off, the hats fall off. Lewis, you're a lot of love, and I think that you're the guy, no matter what, if Mrs. Melk is having a tough day, or I've noticed that when a friend is having a tough day, you're the kid we can count on to always go brighten everybody's day. So you are getting my Sunshine Committee Award. Emma is the little girl that we can't get the crayons and markers out of her hands. Ever. We transition to the rug and she's still just over there, just every white space is covered, and she's got every color imaginable, and she's looking for the colors I don't even know the names of. So she's getting the Amazing Artist Award.
Wow.
Little Miss Zimmerman, Miss Taryn, she's the one who's right behind me all the time saying, Mrs. Melick, can I help you pop out the papers? Mrs. Melick, do you have any pencils I can sharpen? Mrs. Melick, do you want me to turn on the lights for you? So Taryn's getting my helping hand award because she always wants to give me a helping hand. Jacob, you are getting an award because I think since the first day I met you in kindergarten, I don't think I've ever heard something unkind come out of your mouth. And I think you're one of the sweetest kids because you always have nice, kind things to say. So you're getting the Sweetie Pie Award because you have such a cute composition. You guys better watch out because he's going to be the kid everybody wants to be around because he is a sweetie pie. Miss Hayden, another one where I don't think I really have ever had to say to you, Hayden, stop, you're not making the right choice. You have outstanding behavior, so you're getting the best behavior, outstanding behavior award because you just always set good examples for your friends. And that little girl looks just like you with her braids. Sonia, this is so true. When I saw this award, I knew exactly who was getting it. It says future teacher like your paper does, but the best part it says is you can just teach my class. If I'm not.
Okay, you're teaching now. I'm still here, Sonia.
Yep. Jordan.
Yeah,
I named you Miss Manners. Because I tell the kids at lunchtime, if you have a belly to the table and you're eating politely and you're not rolling around on the ground, I take you to Red Robin with me. And I tell her that she's always doing that. So she's a polite, kind young lady. She's my Miss Manners. Miss Janae has all year really been into her letter names and sounds and reading, but I would say this last month or so, I can't get this girl to get her nose out of the book. And so she's wanting to jump on the AR computer. She's wanting another book. Mrs. Melody got that book. So I'm giving you my little bookworm award. This one I could have went back and forth there, Miss Sophia. I could have given you a singing award. I could have given you a dancing award. I could have given you a smiley award. But then when I saw that paper in your hand and I saw this award, I think even when you're at your seat, I always see you kind of singing and humming. So I gave you future singer because you're going to rock American Idol. Yeah, Layton, I asked some of the kids for another reason, you'll find out later, about kids who they always think when I interview kids. Remember when I asked you guys like during your scout time, who always makes good choices, who sets a good example, and who's someone you look up to? And your name came up quite a bit, and I agree. So I have role models, like rock star, because a lot of kids look up to you because you make awesome choices. Aaron, I have you down because you're my boy who loves nature, like Mrs. Mellick. We're always finding cool bugs, flowers, lavender, dandelions, and so you have a love for outside. So you're my future environmentalist. And then there's Molly. She's a lot like some of my friends in here, like Hayden, who follows directions really well. They all do a nice job. But I have you down for being a rule follower queen, because you're always following my rules. So you're the queen of rule following. And those are your kindergartens.